Welcome back to Sisters Up Alive. It is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and our next guest is a breast cancer survivor who did not let a personal setback stop her from building a multi-million dollar hair company. Yes! Now she makes it her mission to educate women on the products they use on a daily basis that could be jeopardizing their health without them even knowing it. Please welcome survivor, amazing woman, and CEO of TGIN, thank God it's natural, Christina Donaldson!
Thank you, Miss Selena. Thank you so much.
Christina, girl!
Yes!
You are a breast cancer survivor.
I am.
And we thank God for you.
Thank you.
Because now you're going to impart all of this knowledge onto us. You were diagnosed at 36. Now, how did you feel getting this diagnosis at such an early age?
I felt so alone and I was shocked. I tell people, when you get diagnosed as breast cancer at 36, particularly as a black woman, mm-hmm. you think that's an old white woman's disease. You mm-hmm. think we get, you know, heart disease, stroke, diabetes. Right. You don't expect to get breast cancer at 36. So
right.
I was completely shocked.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so what were some of the other stressors and struggles that you had to deal with aside from the diagnosis itself? I'm assuming that it was probably financially hard on you as well.
Well, that's why my story is such an interesting one. So when I was diagnosed at a community hospital where uninsured and underinsured women receive health care. Uh-huh. But because of like the success of my business and I was working full-time as a lawyer as well, I had financial resources to get the best health care possible.
Right.
But in the course of seeing that, you know, the fact that other people did not have that option, I saw mm-hmm. little things like child care, who's going to watch your kid, and
right.
who's going to take care of that expense,
right.
transportation, going to the hospital 60 times in a year and paying $14 a day for parking can get to be very expensive. And then
right.
also having the luxury to take time off from work. A lot of women don't have that same luxury mm-hmm. that I did. And so I realized those financial things can be barriers to women's survivorship.
Right. And you are a successful businesswoman. Is that what is all of this is what inspired you to create this amazing line?
Well, yes. But long story short, when I was in corporate America, I wanted to wear my hair kinky mm-hmm. and it wasn't viewed as professional. But my experience with breast cancer has definitely required me to up my game even more. We were already very clean to begin with, but now I'm even more conscious about what I put on my body and what our customers put on theirs.
And so some of the products that you've discovered are susceptible to cause cancer in people.
Correct.
So talk us through some of these products. And this is your line?
Yes. This is not, well, some of the items are our line and some are
just mainstream
products as
okay.
well that we're just going to talk about generally.
Cool.
But there are seven ingredients that we really want to highlight today that you should be on the lookout for when shopping for hair care
right.
products. We're going to start with shampoos.
Okay.
Sulfate-free shampoos have skyrocketed to popularity,
uh-huh.
particularly because they don't strip the hair of its natural oils and it gives you softer, moisturized, and more manageable hair.
Uh-huh.
But what you will see in traditional shampoos are things like ammonium lauryl sulfate
wow.
and sodium lauryl sulfate, and those are chemicals that you want to avoid. So that's more for hair health versus personal health. Secondly, we're going to talk about conditioners.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes within conditioners, you'll see sodium chloride, which is
mm-hmm.
nothing more than the chemical name for salt.
Right.
You want to avoid this, particularly if your hair is curly or even if it's relaxed because it can have
it's drying.
Right. It's a very drying, and if you have scalp issues, it can help to exacerbate those as well. Parabens are something that you hear a lot
parabens.
About in the news today.
Yes.
And the reason why you hear so much about them is because they have the ability to mimic estrogen, which
yes.
is really bad, particularly it can increase the incidence of hormonal-related
right.
breast cancer. What you want to look for when you're shopping for products, people who are manufacturers that actually don't include parabens in their products are generally proud of this. And so for that reason, you should look explicitly for no parabens.
Yeah.
And this one right here actually has it on the side. No sulfates,
yeah.
no paraffins, et cetera.
Yeah.
So
and
that's something you want to be on the lookout
even
for.
Even for baby products, I know that for my kids with lotion and stuff, I look for things that have no parabens. So, and then what about these? This says alcohol.
Right. So not all alcohols are bad, but
mm-hmm.
sometimes you'll see alcohol listed in the back in the ingredients. So
mm-hmm.
Isopropyl alcohol can be drying. That's kind of what you would pick up at a local pharmacy, if you will, to
mm-hmm.
like treat a wound. But sometimes
uh-huh.
you'll find that in hair care products. And if you have curly hair, it can dry it out. But there are also good alcohols like cetyl alcohol and stearyl alcohol, which are found in our leave-in conditioner.
What about perm?
perm, like mm-hmm. sodium hydroxide.
Yeah.
Well, the problem with that, it's not to say that you can't get a relaxer, but it compromises the health of the actual hair strand because mm-hmm. you're taking a chemical, breaking the bonds, and it's actually weakening your hair. But some people are able to have healthy hair with a perm, but mm-hmm. the point is, again, you're chemically altering the state of your hair, which is why it tends to be weaker, brittle, and it'll snap a lot faster. It reduces your elasticity.
Okay, and then what about this right here?
So right here, we are going to talk about formaldehyde. So as more and more women are getting keratin treatments or Brazilian blowouts or even no-chip manicures, their exposure uh-huh. to formaldehyde has increased substantially. Right. And the difference between formaldehyde and parabens is that formaldehyde is actually shown to cause cancer in humans. It's banned not only in parts of the European Union, but in Japan as well. Wow. So you want to kind of steer clear of anything containing formaldehyde. Mm-hmm. And then I think our last thing that we're going to talk about are synthetic fragrances and mm-hmm. synthetic colorants. So usually sometimes you'll see, even on your food, FD&C, that mm-hmm. just means it has like an artificial colorant in mm-hmm. it. If you don't need it, why add it? And so that's kind of always been our philosophy as a line. It's like no artificial colors, mm-hmm. no artificial fragrances. We try to be as natural as possible.
Well, Christia, thank you so much. We are going to keep a lookout for all of these products. And if you want to follow social media to get the list, go to sisterscircle.com or Sisters on Instagram. Up next.